Welcome to this introduction to the stability and strength criteria in LOCOPIAS. The LOCOPIAS main screen shows the main loading parameters, such as draft and trim, and a visual representation of the longitudinal strength properties and the intact stability, which is this bar indicating the actual and allowable vertical center of gravity. When you click the check button that is available from different LOCOPIAS modules, you will directly see if the current loading condition complies with the stability and strength criteria. The other tabs show all the underlying stability and strength criteria. First, we will go through the stability criteria. The first one is the seasonal maximum draft criteria, which can be changed in the settings menu. When you are passing a winter seasonal zone and change to this setting, you will see that the current condition doesn't comply with the maximum winter draft, so we need to reduce the ship's total displacement. The next criteria, T-min4, is a minimum set forward draft, which is a requirement of Classification Society for local strength against slamming. This criteria can be met by trimming the ship by the bow. The minimum sight line from the bridge is set to a maximum of twice the ship's length. When this doesn't comply, then the ship needs to be trimmed by the bow. Any obstructions also limit the sight line, so a rearrangement of the deck cargo can also improve the sight line. The initial stability is represented by the metacentric height GM, which is set to a minimum of 0.15. When it doesn't comply, it can be changed by lowering the cargo center of gravity or by ballasting the lower ballast tanks. When we take a further look at the criteria at the moment when the minimum metacentric height didn't comply, then it is also visible that the criteria for the area under the GZ curve didn't comply. These do comply after the changes we made, but with some other ship designs, there might be a possibility that some of these stability criteria won't comply while the minimum metacentric height is sufficient. Reducing the draft will increase the area under the GZ curve, and the lowering of the center of gravity is also a solution in these cases. The main screen contains a visual representation of the allowable and actual VCG, with the shortage or surplus clearly visible. The maximum VCG represented here is the lowest one for the current draft and trim. This means that it gives a clear visualization for the stability criteria, so it is an easy way to see the compliance of the current loading condition. The wind criteria are made to ensure that ships will also remain stable in severe wind conditions. The wind area of the ship has a negative influence on the ship's behavior in wind conditions, so in this case containers or other cargo on deck have a negative impact. But the ship's general stability, which is also represented by the GZ curve that is visible in the LOCOPIAS main screen, also influences the behavior in wind conditions. A clearer visualization of the wind criteria can be seen in the intact stability output. In this case, it is visible that the area under the GZ curve is too small for the wind criteria, so the problem can be solved by lowering the cargo's weight or by ballasting the bottom tanks, which we will do in this case. This positively influences the stability of the ship, which can be seen by a clearly larger area under the GZ curve. Now it is also visible in the intact stability output that this makes the ship comply with the wind criteria, also with the containers still on deck. The strength section of the check screen consists of a list of the shear forces and the bending moments, with their respective allowed values at certain readout points, which are set by the Classification Society in order to prevent buckling or breaking of the ship. The forces and moments need to be within these limits, at and in between the readout points, in order to comply. A visual representation of the ship's current forces and moments is visible on the LOCOPIAS main screen. In this case, the ship is unevenly loaded with only cargo at the front and aft of the ship. This causes severe hogging and a bending moment that is greater than the allowance. However, when the ship remains in port in this situation, then the harbor condition can be selected in the settings menu, which allows larger moments and forces. If the ship needs to sail with the current stowage, then it is possible to keep the moments within the limits by adding weight in the middle of the ship, which we'll do by adding ballast. If there is still any uncertainty about any part of LOCOPIAS, it is possible to open the manual by pressing the F1 key. The manual will open on the part that is about the currently open module. Thank you for watching this introduction video to the stability and strength criteria in LOCOPIAS. The links to the online manual and LOCOPIAS page are included in the description of this video, as well as a demo version of LOCOPIAS.